Hello everyone, welcome to our channel SMS Tech Edu. Today's video is about EIS, Electrochemical Impedance Spectroscopy. So what is EIS? It's a powerful technique that utilizes a small amplitude alternating current signal to probe the impedance characteristic of a cell. Here the AC signal is scanned over a wide range of frequencies to generate an impedance spectrum. This EIS is useful in different research fields like batteries and corrosion. Earlier we uploaded a video on potentiodynamic polarization test, that is the Teffel plot. So I think by now you can do the corrosion analysis of your sample very well. You can determine the V-core and I-core value of your system. So EIS is for those who want to do more in-depth corrosion analysis of your samples. Considering the experimental perspective, it's a highly sensitive and complex characterization technique which establishes the electrical response of a chemical system. The basic electrode setup is similar to a potentiodynamic polarization test, that is one reference electrode, counter electrode and working electrode, and the nature of this test is non-destructive. Therefore, before performing a potentiodynamic polarization test, actually you can run an EIS test.
Okay, let's begin with the EIS experimental interface and various parameters associated with it. As you can see, this is the EC Lab software EIS interface, and these are the various parameters which are very commonly used during the EIS measurement. Here the FI and FF is the frequency range, and it is generally selected from 100 kHz to 10 mHz, but you can change it to different frequency range as per your requirement. Here the amplitude is set as 10 millivolt generally, but that also can be changed as per your need. So after running the experiment, you will get a file like this. So thereafter you have to analyze your data. Here analysis means you have to design an equivalent circuit corresponding to the Nyquist and Bode plots of your results. Therefore, before going to the analysis part, it's more important that you have some basic idea of your system, so that once you have the Nyquist and Bode plots, you can easily predict the equivalent circuit to fit the data and to explain the material system. Therefore, if you are new to this field, I will suggest to do extensive literature study and design your own equivalent circuit based on your EIS plots. Coming to the analysis part, there are various softwares available to fit the EIS data. Today I will show two different softwares, ZView and EC Lab. As per my experience, ZView is more handy, but you have to purchase its license version. For EC Lab, you can use the demo version.
Okay, so let's begin with the ZView software analysis. So this is the ZView software interface. To add files, you have to select files and data files options. So this box will appear, from where you have to select your files. Select it and then add it. You can add multiple files also for comparison purpose. Here I have selected two files, so let's see. So this is the Nyquist plot and these are the Bode plots. You can see two plots appeared here because I selected two files. Right click and then do the auto scale. Same thing for Bode plots also. Okay. So let's analyze this black line, which is the 6 hour slot. For that I have to select it first. So this file is selected. You can see there are two capacitive loops in this Nyquist plot. So coming to the instant fitting option, okay, let's click this instant fitting. You can see this box will appear, which is having very simple equivalent circuit. So let's select this option. Okay, you can see a fitting graph is appeared here, but the fitting is not perfect because it is the fitting is happening around only the second capacitive loop. The first loop is not being fitted. So for that, I have to go to this equivalent circuit option, and then I have to manually draw. You can edit and add a new component here. First, I will add a resistor. Okay, then again right click, add a constant phase element. Then in parallel, one resistor. Then in series, one resistor. Or you can edit it also. This would be constant phase element. And again in parallel, one resistor. So my equivalent circuit is now complete. Then you have to change this fixed values to free ones. Okay, so you have to give some values here, otherwise this fitting will not work. For that, go to this edit fit parameter options. Okay, so first select the frequency range as for your experiment. So I told earlier that my experiment was performed from 100 kilohertz to 10 millihertz. Then select this fitting option, not the simulation. Select this okay. Now you have to give some values here, otherwise the fitting will not work. So for the second loop, I will take the values from this instant fitting option. Simply click and drag it. So the values will be copied from the instant fitting to the advanced fitting. For this R1 and CPE values, you have to put values manually. So let's put this value 0.0004 and this 1.9. And then I will click on this run fitting option and see what is happening. Now you can see this fitting is perfect for both the Nyquist and Bode plots. So what happens if the fitting is not perfect? What you will do then? So again go to this edit parameter options, and this time you select the simulation option, not the fitting option, and click on OK. Now if you change these values, the graph will be changed as you change the parameters. So I changed it to 500. Let's run the simulation. You can see that the graph is changing. Again, I will put it back to its original value. Okay, so let's change this R2 value from 80 to 100 and see what is happening. You can see a shift is happening here. So let's put it back to earlier values, that is 80. So you continue to change the values of the parameters till the time the fitting is perfect. So in this case, the fitting is perfect. I have to export the values. To export, go to file and go to this option, copy model to clipboard, and paste it. Okay, so these are the parameters. Okay, so how to plot this Nyquist plots in origin? For that, I have to go to this data values option. So this is giving all the values. So I have to get the values from the actual graph as well as from the fitted graph. So for that, first I have to select the actual graph, this 6 hours 2, and then right click, copy all to clipboard option. So this all values are selected. Now go to the Excel file and then paste it. I will change the sheet name to actual one, and then I will create another sheet for sheet 2, and I will select the name as fit. Again go to the ZView, and this time you select this fit result option. Again copy all to clipboard. So these are the values from the fitted result, and in the sheet 2 in Excel sheet, paste it. Okay, so first I will take the values from the actual file. I will select this file, these two columns. I will copy it and paste it in origin. Okay, and then I will select these two columns from the fitting, copy it and paste it in origin. Okay, so this is the actual file and this is the fitting file. Let's select this file, this column as X. Okay, so this Z double dash is imaginary one, so you have to set column values as -1. For that, do like this: column B equal to column B into -1. Click on OK. So this values will be now negative. Again, do the same thing for the fitting. Select the set column values. Here this column D equal to column D into -1. So these values will be turned negative. Okay, so let's plot this actual one as scattered plot. This is the first graph, and let's plot this fitting one as line plot. Okay, so this is the second one. Then you have to merge it. Go to graph and then merge graph windows, open dialog option. This box will appear. You have to uncheck this rearrange layout option. Okay, then click on OK option. So this will give your the final Nyquist plot. So similar thing you have to do for the Bode plots also. From this actual files, you select this frequency, and then as x-axis and y-axis, you select this magnitude phase. So Bode plots can also be plotted in the origin. Okay, so let's go to the EC Lab software now. So these are the files. So these files I have fitted in ZView software. Now I will double click it and it will directly open in the EC Lab software. Click on OK. So you can see this is the Nyquist plot, and to change it to Bode plot, I have to select this Bode impedance option. So these are the Bode impedance and Bode phase plots. So the difference you can see with the ZView software is that there you can see all the three plots all together, but in EC Lab you have to see it in different windows. Okay, so how to fit? Go to analyze and select this electrochemical impedance spectroscopy option and select this Z fit. Okay, then you have to select the equivalent circuit. So go to this edit option, this one. So this box will appear, and here you have to select your required equivalent circuit. So I have selected this one and then click on OK. Okay, so then you click on this minimize option. Okay, you click this calculate and minimize option till the time it is the fitting is perfect. Okay, now it is perfectly fitted. So this is the Nyquist impedance fitting. You can check the Bode impedance fitting also. So this fitting is also somewhat perfect. Okay, so how to export these values, select this copy option here, and then you can paste it here in the Word. Okay, so this is the ZView fitting, and this is the EC Lab fitting. Okay, so the fitting from both the software is almost same. This R3 values, here it is 650, here it is 651, this R1 value is 78, here it is 80. So the fitting is almost same for both the softwares. So you can use any of the software as per your convenience. Okay, so this is our first video in EIS. If you want to learn more about this electrochemical impedance spectroscopy, or if you want some more videos on corrosion, like, comment and share. You can put your valuable comments in the suggestion box. Thank you for watching our videos.